Marami salamat po. Please take your seats. Thank you so much. My favorite and best professor. My LaSalle days. History, political science. She was indeed my best professor, Professor Sok Reyes. Sa lahat po ng mga organizers ng event na ito, I understand this is the first of a series of events dubbed as Buhay at Babae, fighting or upholding for human rights, women's rights, and democracy. Hindi ko na sahin yung mga nandito, baka meron po akong ma-miss. But of course, special mention, former chair, Etta Rosales, the beacon also of women's rights, and Commissioner Karen. Karen, I always say this, she was my mentor. Nung baguhan pa lang ako, bagita pa lang ako sa usapin ng karapatang pantao when I joined CHR in 2008. Yes, I'm back home. And yet, I feel great to be back here, my original home, the Commission on Human Rights. Marami ho kayong mga nandito. Sa inyo pong lahat. Again, I would not mention na lang po isa-isa, baka meron ho akong mamiss sa inyo. Sa panahon po kung kailan lantaran akong pinagtutulungan at tinaba, kinukuyod ng mga lalaking kapwa ko nagtatrabaho sa gobyerno, kanino pa nga ba ako kukuha ng lakas kundi sa mga kapwa ko, mga babae. I'm still here. Huwag ho kayong mag-alala. Siguro yung iba sa inyo nagtataka, ba't nandyan pa siya? Ba't nakatayo pa siya? Ba't buhay pa siya? Nandito pa po ako at habang po, lalaban po ako. Sa darating na linggo ay ang 100th araw sa pwesto ni Pangulong Duterte. Pero ngayon pa lang, ubabot na sa 3,675 ang napatay. 1,381 dito ang napaslang sa operasyon ng pulis. Habang nakakaalarmang 2,294 ang napatay na hindi tukoy ang salarin o maituturing na kagagawan ng mga so-called vigilante. Mahigit 30 tao napatay kada araw. And the numbers are growing by the day. Karamihan po dito, kung hindi man lahat sila, ay pawang mahihirap at pawang walang boses sa lipunan. Naalala ko rito ang isang sulat sa akin ng isa pong supporter. Hindi ko po siya kilala personally, pero ang ganda po ng sulat niya sa akin. Ang pangalan po niya, Ginoong Archimedes Marquez. Sabi niya po, quote, "If the pusher lives in a tondo shanty on a river of garbage, he dies violently in an encounter with police. If the dealer conducts pot session in a condo unit where illegal drugs worth millions are found, he gets to live surrounded by the media. Big-time drug lords have the hospital or the PNP White House to take refuge in. Small-time pushers have only cemeteries to await them after their ignominious death," end of quote. From a plain citizen. Kamanghang-mangha po ang nagaganap sa ating lipunan ngayon. Buhay at babae, ang tema po natin ngayon, angkop na angkop sa mga nangyayari ngayon. And allow me please to dwell largely on the issue of women, issue ng babae, women's rights, women's dignity. As many of you now know, over the last 8 years, I have been to scores of events like this. Human rights consciousness events that further the advocacy for women's rights through awareness of women's issues. I have delivered dozens of speeches before hundreds, if not thousands, of audience members about the same or similar issues over the course of that same time period. While each event is unique in its own way, which made it easier to tailor for the message appropriately and accordingly. The overall theme was mostly the same. The celebration of progress and achievements of the women's rights movements, the acknowledgement of challenges that remain, thoughts on how to address and overcome those remaining challenges, acknowledging the growing awareness and participation of men in addressing women's issues, yet calling for much more in the future, and basically speaking from my own experiences as a public servant, a lawyer, a daughter, a mother, a sister, and in general, as a woman. But this year, this event we're holding at this very moment, coming off of my experiences this last few months, iba po ito. Ibang iba ito. Aaminin ko na sa dinarami-rami ng mga pinagdaanan ko bilang isang babae, bilang anak, kapatid, asawa, separada, abogada, chairperson ng Commission on Human Rights, kalihim ng tagapagtanggol ng mga nabiktima ng karahasan at ng sa karapatan. I'll just hold this perhaps. It's distracting me. Lalo na ang kanilang karapatang pantao, akala ko ay maalam at veterano na po ako pagdating sa buhay, lalo na sa tema ng buhay babae. Life has a funny way of teaching you lessons in the least expected and yes, quite painful and traumatic ways. Just when you think that at a particular age, although I'm not that old yet, and with all these life and professional experiences, there are no longer any big life lessons to be learned. Life happens, things happen, and prove you wrong. Pinaramdam sa akin ng kapalaran na may isang aspeto ng pagkababae na hindi ko pa pala lubos na nararanasan. Ang maging biktima. A victim. Not in the general sense of being a woman who has encountered the sort of sexism that pervades the daily life that women unfortunately have come to expect as part of their daily routine, but as a victim of targeted, unrelenting, vicious, malicious, and intentionally destructive attacks virtually from all directions, both from known and unknown assailants. Admit, as a beloved daughter who has had an upbringing that was more comfortable than most have had the fortune to experience, and as a student, and later, as a professional whose aptitude and capacity for academics and for the acquisition of skills has made life quite fulfilling, despite being very challenging and demanding, I realized that I lived a relatively sheltered life. I've been living in a bubble without even realizing it. A self-aware bubble to some extent, to be sure, because I knew at some level that there are real problems still pervading our society and real victims surviving through them. But it is nonetheless a bubble that not even close exposure to victims as an advocate can truly break. There are things that you think you can learn vicariously, but at some point you will realize, as I have, that nothing adequately prepares you for the shock, the pain, the trauma, the bouts of helplessness, the moments of doubt, and through it all, the vague feeling of unreality, of being trapped in a surrealistic nightmare. The very absurdity of which makes it difficult to comprehend, much more fight to escape and wake up from, that come with becoming a victim. Noon po, kapag nasa harapan ko po ang nabiktima, umaandar agad ang utak ko. Ano ang nangyari? Bakit nangyari? Ano ang pwede gawin para mahinto ng tuluyan ng pang-aabuso? Ano ang dapat pang mangyari at gawin para huwag nang maulit ang pang-aabuso o managdagan pa ang pagmabibiktima? Sino ang dapat managot? Etc., etc. Ako mismo, mabilis po akong kumilos. Umaandar ka at tapang ko. Pag natuon ko na ang karapat dapat gawin, action agad. That's what I would normally do. I normally am an action woman. But when I was on the receiving end of a relentless slew of blow after blow, blow of unmitigatedly unfair, underhanded, and out of bounds lies and attacks against my humanity and woman, I met a part of myself that up to that point, up to this point, I didn't know existed. Yung parte ng pagkatao ko na napapainda sa mga suntok ng kalaban. Yung parte na napapahinto at napapatahimik paminsan-minsan, lalo na kapag wala sa mata ng publiko. When I was in the privacy of my room at night, only with my favorite dog, Coco. Yung parte ng pagko na parang walang makaalpas sa pinaka masasakit na dagok ay kinailangang maging manhid at tuod pansamantala. Opo, maging manhid pansamantala. It's definitely a darker side of me. The woman who has had sleepless nights, the woman who sat and contemplated what had she done to deserve such treatment. Days, the woman who began to believe that maybe, just maybe, this is punishment for daring not just to be human, but to be a woman. The woman who was driven to such frustration that she was forced against her act and speak in public without the filter of the professional, quote unquote. Just like what you saw the other night when I was ganged up in that hearing by men. But she is definitely, this part of me is definitely a part of me. And I am privileged, I must tell you, to have met her. For she is also the survivor in me. The one who, after those dark moments, somehow found another reserve of strength to tap from in order to fight and counter the submission hold she found herself momentarily trapped in. Kumbaga sa martial arts, she is the ultimate fighting champion in me because more than just a pony. For she is also the side of me who found the capacity against all odds to find forgiveness for those who were forced to tell lies against her and betray her. Hindi ko na naman po alam kung sino-sino na naman ang mga ipapaharap bukas dyan sa house inquiry na yan na maglalantaran na magsisinungaling. For she understood, that part of me understood what it felt like to be helpless, to be held against her will, to be victimized. For she is the side of me that accepted that she is, after all, a woman, and that is nothing to ask anyone's forgiveness for. She can be vulnerable, at times frail, at times longing for love, human contact, and human expression. Yet, and precisely by accepting those side of her, she, at all times and no matter what, will never be any less of a person, no less of worth to any man or any other woman. She is the side of me that realizes that there is no need to be ashamed or be silent about the parts of her that make her a woman. But Also, and perhaps more importantly, the one who realizes there is no need to break that silence just to satisfy others' voyeuristic desires. Meron pong post sa social media, recently posted, that really bothered me. Ito po yun. Sabi niya, siyempre pitinakpan na lang po namin ang pangalan niya, baka maging object of ano rin po siya. Bobo talaga ang mga dilaw. Pare-pareha sila mag-isip. Just because Duterte admitted in public he killed 1,700 does not mean he meant it. Ako ba pag sinabi ko na nang-rape ako na 1,700 women to boost my masculinity in public means I actually raped 1,700 women? Bobo lang. So marami po talaga pala tayong bobo dito. Amazing. Knee-jerk reaction is to be upset about the suggestion that a violation of one woman, let alone the hypothetical 1,700 women, that's hypothetical for the rape, but I don't think that's hypothetical for the killings, is a means to boost a person's masculinity. Even more upset to think that there are actually living, breathing organisms occupying space both in the physical world and in the cyberspace who actually think that this is acceptable reasoning, to say nothing of those who press the like button. Sana walang mga nagla-like sa inyo sa mga ganyan na mga kagaguhan. Knee-jerk reaction is to scream at the top of my lungs that women are not instruments of any other person's sense of completion. We are not objects. We are not means to achieving other people's satisfaction. Hindi tayo ari nagagamitin para himasin ang pagkalalaki ng mga taong kulang sa pag-iisip, kulang sa pagkalalaki, at kulang sa pagiging tao. Plenty of those. I just never realized that aside from one flaming misogynist sitting in the highest echelon of power who thinks rape jokes are actually funny, let alone worthy of a president, I would also be working so closely with some of them. I have had to sit there and roll my eyes to the ceiling as unparliamentary innuendos about the Visayan term libog and the surname of a lawyer for a witness being malaki were made in the middle of a serious matter in order to just to satisfy their phallic obsession, or perhaps more accurately, insecurities. But I realized that that's how they get to us. We are lulled more. We are lulled by humor. Women's issues are trivialized by jokes. Pwede ba natin makinig kayo? Sound please. Audio. This is just 20 seconds. That's our president. By the mentality that it's okay to make jokes about them and we are being overly sensitive or KJ by not finding them appropriate. Kaya siguro ilan sa atin, without realizing it, laugh along or at least huff out an amused breath or perhaps smile a little to indicate we have a sense of humor. This is not about having a sense of humor, but about having sensitivity towards real issues affecting women. By going along, by laughing along, by keeping silent or allowing ourselves to be bullied into silence, we are unconsciously being groomed to laugh at abuse, and in so laughing, becoming abusers ourselves. Pilit nila tayong ipinipinta sa kulay nila. Pilit tayong ipinabababa sa level nila. But we don't let it happen. In standing up against comments like this delivered at inappropriate settings and fora, I commend some of our journalists, both men and women, for calling out the blatant hypocrisy and misogyny that underpin these comments. May iba naman na mas matinik. Walang mailabas na credible evidence against me, so they consciously use the old sex, drugs, and violence approach. Sex, drugs, and violence approach to shield their hypocrisy and incompetence. Meron pa nga dyan. Tagapagtanggol ko no ng mga kababaihan, lalo na ng mga tinaguriang comfort women. Pero yun, nagsusulong na ipa-forensic analysis ko no yung fake video na pilit nilang idinuduldol sa harap ng taong bayan. To what end? Malupit kong isipin na ang pagtatanggol pala sa mga high-profile cases involving women's issues ay balak kayo lamang pala para mahalal sa posisyon. Once again, women are used for a man's ambitions. But the issue is deeper. The really disturbing part is that there are people in power who are truly, honestly, and perhaps even unapologetically out of touch. It has been reported that one lawmaker, after once again satisfying his obsession with the sex video, this time by actually watching it and commenting, the partner was good, was asked by a fellow young reporter whether showing the sex video would be a form of slut shaming and phallic domination. That was the question of that female reporter. The reaction in the room reportedly was silence, followed by this lawmaker asking, meron bang ganun? Referring to the slut shaming. Yes, Representative Danilo Suarez, to answer your question, there is such a thing. And to help you and your even further towards the path of enlightenment, Section 9, Paragraph C of the Magna Carta of Women, which I'm sure you have heard of, you being a lawmaker and all, states that, quote, all government personnel involved in the protection and defense of women against gender-based violence shall undergo a mandatory training on human rights and gender sensitivity pursuant to this act, end of quote. And since you, as a lawmaker, presumably swore to protect the rights of women, may I kindly suggest that you and your wise colleagues all undergo such training. Just a thought. Maybe in your wisdom, you'll ask about it so that next time when a young reporter asks you about slut shaming, you wouldn't be caught with your pants down again, so to speak. So, what is slut shaming? To me, it's simple. It's making us women ashamed of an essential part of our being, our sexuality. Not because only women have or experience it. If all the phallic jokes and fascination with the sexual act and footage thereof is any indication, But because, well, apparently, because we are women and apparently we have no right to own and enjoy our sexuality. Men can boast about all the women they've bedded and conquered. But it's a mortal sin if a woman even dares to embrace her sexuality. A single woman having a physical relationship with a man, she's a slut. Crucify her. No, wait. That's a man's punishment. Stone her to death. But he's good. He's a stud. Is there a vacant government post that we can elevate by his election or appointment? Because obviously there's a born leader right there. There's also a socio-economic divide, if you will notice. Women who have means or are favorably situated can get an annulment or divorce from abusive or otherwise incompatible partners. They can shed the stigma of being so-called adulterers or unfaithful to an extent, though not completely. But heaven forbid, should a woman live an abusive husband or be abandoned by her husband or otherwise separate from her husband without any means to obtain a legal or church annulment, and yet dare to try to find happiness in another relationship, she will be labeled, she will be judged, she will be maligned, she will be vilified, she will be measured as being less, whatever that means, no matter the circumstances. As for men, in some people's eyes, they need not even bother with the legalities or legalities, and they would still be revered for their so-called virility. Apparently, we're good enough for pleasuring our partners, giving birth to our children, taking care of them, but heaven forbid we actually dare to own our sexuality, to find pleasure in human relationships and contact. If we do, you are women of the world. We are immoral. We should all go and hang ourselves. Sabi po niya yun. No, you don't own us. If mothers have to go through the pain of birthing us into this world, the list, the absolute very least we make it business, whether she enjoyed the process of conception. It is no one's business but a woman's, and to some extent her partner's, but ultimately her. Contemplating the social media post I mentioned before, yung pinakita ko po kanina, I realized something. This person, that person who posted that, might not be stupid. In fact, the blatant crassness might be hinting not so much at appalling sincerity, but sarcasm. It's easier on Reddit than Facebook, for example, because commenters there appear to use the sarcasm button more often, whereas this post is vague. It's perfectly phrased to garner as many reactions as possible from all sides. You can like it if you actually agree, you can get angry if you don't, and you can laugh at it if you actually manage to discern the irony and the sarcasm. Because just as our victimizers have learned the craft of weaponizing humor, so did our supporters. Those who would otherwise be too afraid of getting trolled, bullied, or worse, if they dare stand up for women and women's issues as exemplified and amplified in this surreal quagmire I find myself facing these days, are fighting back using humor. It just goes to show that even the defenders need defending. We need to stand. We need to stand ourselves, and we need to stand up for each other. What pains me most is seeing women defending this kind of behavior. Perhaps that's one of the greatest offenses against our cause. The women are turned or being turned against each other. It is perhaps only to the offense of polluting the minds of the future generation, of passing on a legacy of misogyny, of abusive behavior towards women, making girls feel lesser in worth than boys, of giving them less freedom and less ownership over their body, their life, and their future, of taking away from the boys the chance to develop a sense of accountability for their actions, that better persons, sons, brothers, partners, husbands. Corrupt our children long before they even have the chance to make their own decisions and choices, and robs them of the opportunity to fulfill their potential of evolving into the best human beings they can be. But for each other and for our children, we have to stand up, throw caution to the wind, and be nothing more and nothing less than a woman. Babae ako. Hindi ako nahihiya sa aking pagkababae. Wala akong dapat ikahiya sa aking pagkababae. I don't deserve it. And when I am abused, it's not because I am at fault, not because I was asking for it, not because I deserved it, but because my abusers aren't intelligent enough to recognize my value, to appreciate me, and respect me. That is the lesson I learned from the Leila I have had the pain and the pleasure to get to know this past few months. I thank her for the lessons. I thank her for being strong, for being who she is, for embracing who she is, her weaknesses, and her humanity. All of this have made me stronger, and whether I want it or not, allowed me a greater affinity with my fellow victims. No, not victims, fellow survivors, who, of our trials, not be the exact same persons we were before, but will nonetheless listen all our experiences and triumphs over our trials. No, diamonds are not a girl's best friend. Concocted by society to dominate a woman by making her feel like she's only as valuable as a material possession. No, if there is any way that a diamond can compare to a woman, is in its strength. A woman is resilient, a woman is unbreakable. But unlike a woman, a diamond can't bend. It isn't malleable. A woman, even when she's weak, she's strong. Even when she bends, she remains whole. In the face of different challenges, she can adapt and find ways to survive and triumph. That's the foe that my detractors and my so-called face, let them tremble. And maraming salamat po.